Welcome back to Tech Project. Today we are going to make GUI Scientific Calculator in Java using Eclipse. Take a look what we are going to make. You can see this is Scientific Calculator which is in off condition now. But when I click on, then I perform every operation on it. And you can see it has a multiple operation like sine, cos, tan. And I tell you one more way by which you add more and more operation just by writing a single line. So let's start. Open the Eclipse, go to File, then New, then Java Project, give any name and click on Finish. Now right click on your project, select New, then Other. Here you have to select Window Builder, then Swing Designer and then Application Window. And then give any name and click on Finish. We create the design for our calculator. So go to design, resize the J-frame according to your choice. Now select absolute layout from the layouts. Select J-label. I rename it as scientific calculator. You can write anything here according to you. Change the font size and the font also. And then resize it. Now select J-text field where all number and text are display. Now take J button, fix its size and change its font and font size according to you. We want 35 button in our calculator, 5 column with 7 rows. First we complete one column, so just copy and paste the button. Resize your J-frame according to one column of your calculator. Resize your J-frame again according by which 7 button easily fixed in one column. Or you can create your own design whatever you want. Now we want 4 more columns. So select the first button, then select all button one by one by click control on your laptop or PC with the help of mouse. Now copy the entire column by the help of control plus C and then paste it. You can see one column is getting copied. By this, first complete the design of our calculator. Now check it by running and it looks fine. To make it more attractive, I just increase the size of 0 button. Now we have to change the text of all button and name of the button. Click on button, retext it as 1 and give name btn1. You can give anything. For simplicity, I just take small name. Follow the same procedure for all buttons from 0 to 9. Now change the text for the operator. First I made a dot button and rename it btn dot. You don't have to need rename all button, just rename from 0 to 9 and basic operator like plus, minus, multiply, divide, equal and percentage. I want 0 to 9 as bold font and all other button in plain font. So I select a button and change its font to plain. Now I copy this button after deleting some button in this column. Now I change the text to the operator and also rename it. For backspace, I give the button name as btn backspace and write the text of capital B. Further, I tell you how to give the backspace symbol. Now I change the font and copy this font in entire third row and change the text. Now our basic calculator is complete. Now we have to change the text for scientific calculator. I want all other buttons in a plain font, so I just change the font. It is your choice whether you want to change it or not. Sometime you write something on button as a text, but it's not a pair, only three dots are pair due to its large size. In that case, you just have to decrease the font size. For scientific function, you don't need to change the button name, just only change the text. In this video, I use the function logarithmic, exponent, power, cube, factorial, sine, cos, tan. But you can add any function if you want. During the coding, I tell you way how to implement any function if you want. After completing, I write capital R for root function. Further, I tell you how to give the root symbol. Now our design is complete, and now we want on a button, so select J radio button, change its text to on, and also change its font according to you. Now copy this and paste it and change the text to off. Design of our calculator is finished. By running, we can see it look perfect. Now it's time for coding part. First we write the code for clear button. So just double click on clear button and we directly reach to code where we have to write. Or there is another way. Just right click on clear button, then select add event handler and then select action perform. Now we want our text field is null when we click on clear button, so just write text field dot set text null. Now we have to take number from the user, so write the code from 0 to 9 and for dot button, so just double click on any button from 0 to 9. Here we want take a number from user, so declare a string. I declare a string number which get text from user. Now I want to set the text to the text field, so just write text field dot set text number. Now write the same code for all button from 0 to 9, just change the button name. Now check it by running and we can see it start taking number. I just change the font of the text field here. Now write the code for simple operator like plus minus, multiply, divide, percentage, because these operators are different from scientific ones, because it want two number to perform an operation, but all other scientific operations require only one number. So just double click on any operator. For these, first I declare some variable to store the number, double first, double second, we store the number from the user. Result, store the current result. Operation hold, which operation going to be done, and answer store the final result. Now go to design, click on operator. Now we have to write the code. First I assign the number which is entered by user into first. Then I set the text field null. Now in operation variable, I hold the operation which is going to be done. Now write the same code for plus minus multiply divide and percentage. Now we write the code for equal button. So just double click on equal. First we take second number from user and store into second variable. Now write if else condition. If else condition match to which operation going to be done. If operation equal plus plus, then we write code result equal first plus second. Now convert the string and store the result into answer. Now display the answer to text field. Now write the same code for all remaining operator. Just change the operator sign and replace if by else if. And you can see our basic calculator is done. Now we write the code for backspace button. So just double click on backspace, declare a string named backspace and assign null to it. Check the length of input string is greater than 0 or not. Now declare a string builder object which takes string from text. Reduce the size of the string by 1 and display the new string to the text field. If you want to change the capital letter B to backspace symbol, so just write backspace U F O E 7 and change the font from Tahoma to Wingdings. By running, we can see everything is perfect. I just bold the font of percentage, clear and backspace operator to make it attractive. It's your choice to whether you want to do or not. Now it's time to write the code for scientific function. First we write the code for sine function. So just double click on sine, take a number from text field which is entered by user. Simultaneously perform the sine operation and store the result into A. The sine operation is performed by the inbuilt function mat.sine. With the help of math library of Java, you can implement any scientific function in an easy way. Now set the text field null and display the answer. Sorry, I do a little mistake. I write a sine instead of sine. Now copy and paste the same code for all function but not for factorial, square, cube and x raised to power y. For cos, just write mat.cos. For tan, just write mat.tan. For sin h, just write mat.sin h. For cos h, just write mat.cos h. For tan h, just write mat.tan h. For log, just write mat.log. And for exponential, write it mat.exp. For 1 divided by x, just divide the number by 1 and remove the scientific function. Now check if this function is working or not, and we can see it worked perfectly. Only first column code written is left. Start writing the code of plus minus symbol. Just double click on it, store a number which is entered by user and perform operation a is equals to a multiply bracket minus 1 and then semicolon. Display the answer to the text field. A string.value function return int from string. Now write code for factorial. Just double click on it, take a number from user, declare a fact variable which hold 1. You can use for loop, I use while loop. The main answer is stored in fact variable textfield.setText brackets textfield.getText plus fact. For square, first I copy the same code of any scientific function like sine, cost or anything. Now just take a number and multiply it by itself. Remove the scientific function and then display the answer. For cube, follow the same procedure. Just multiply the same number by 3 times. Now write the code for root function. Copy and paste the any scientific function code and replace the math.sign by math.sqrt. If you want root symbol, then replace capital R by backslash U, 221 and A. Check it by run and you can root symbol has come and the code is worked perfectly. Now write the code for x raised to power y. This code is different. It works as like plus minus multiply operators because it need two number to perform an operation. So copy the any symbol operator code and paste it here and change the operation to x raised to power y. Now go to design and double click on equal and write else if operation here. Else if operation is equals to x raised to power y, then we have to execute following code. You can write code according to you or you can use my method. I declare a result t variable and assign 1 to it and I use for loop to evaluate this. Multiply the first number by result t because we want multiply the same number to that time we store in the second variable and store the final result into result t variable. Now change the result to result t in the below line. By check it running and we can say it worked fine. Now our calculator is ready. Only on off operation is left. If you don't need to use on off operation, then you can leave the video. Now for on off button, we have to create a group of these two buttons because we want on or off at one time. Just click on on button and right click on it, select button group and then select new standard. Now right click on off button and you can see here a button group name has been come. So just select it, check it by running whether it is working or not and you can see it work fine. On clicking off button, we want every button does not work. Go to the code of off button. So just write every button name, then dot, then set enable and pass false to it. First I write this statement for only one button. On running, I see it worked perfectly. Now write the same code for every button, just change the button name and write the code also for text field. If you don't know where is the button name, so just click on button. On the left side, there is a property window on which variable is written and just right side of the variable, the button name is displayed. After writing all button name and pass false to it, We check it whether it is working or not, and we can see clearly it worked fine. Now copy the same code for on button. Just replace the false by true, because on clicking on button, we want every button function properly. Now check it whether it is working or not, and it worked perfect. One thing is left, that when I click on off button, then it working. By default, it is not in off state. To make it by default in off state, we just have to click on button, go to its property which is on left side, and deselect the enable option and make it false. Follow the same process for every button of the calculator and for text field also. And also we want off button by default selected, so just click on off button and made it true, where selected is written. Now our complete scientific calculator is ready. One thing is left, when I click on off button, it does not clear the screen. So just go to design, double click on off button, or go to the code of off button and just write here text field dot set text null. If you want a desktop icon, then select your project, go to file, and then click on export. Here you have to select runnable jar file, which is in Java option. Select your project in launch configuration, give any different name, and click on finish. You can see your project come on the desktop and work perfectly. Thank you guys for watching this video. I hope you like this video. Please subscribe my channel. Thank you.